Hey everyone, John here to share with you what's new in Particle Illusion 2024. And in Particle Illusion 2024, we've harnessed the power of AI for next level sprite creation. We've added inherited velocity for more realistic simulations. We've enhanced lines with a new 3D option, and we've added more parameters into the host, plus more. Let's take a look. Particle Illusion is an image or sprite-based particle system, and it requires good-looking sprites to get good results. In Particle Illusion 2024, we've harnessed the power of generative AI to allow you to create great-looking particles and also to up-res existing particles. Let's take a look. When you open up the Particle Shape Editor, and you can access that by double-clicking on the particle, down here in the bottom right is a new button called Generate. And if I click that, that opens up the interface into Stability AI's Stable Diffusion Generative AI. And you will need an account, which you can create at dreamstudio.ai. To generate images, we use prompts. And getting the wording right for prompts can be a bit tricky sometimes. To help with that, PI uses a seed image. And this helps focus the generation without having to be too specific. Now, for this demonstration, I'd like to actually create some feathers. And we could go back into the sprite library by cancelling here and choosing a feather, but we could also use a preset. And I'm finding this is a great way to start. So to load a preset, we click load. And if we just have a look down the list here, here's a feather. So if I click apply, that populates the interface with the settings that we used to create this preset. Notice how the seed image is kind of the shape of a feather, but it's not actually a feather. It just has to look roughly like what you're looking for. And for this, the prompt is also pretty simple. So with these settings, all I have to do is set the number of images. I'm just going to leave it at 4 and click Generate. After a few seconds, you'll see the images that were generated. I'm going to choose this one and click Import. This opens up the standard Import Particle dialog. So I'll leave these settings as they are and click Apply. And apply once more. All right, so now rather than that soft blur, I've got these feathers in this scene. What a difference that makes. Let's try another example. This is some pop-up grass that ships with Particle Illusion 2023.5. And maybe I want to try different kinds of grass. So once again, I'll double-click, open up the Particle Shape Editor, and click Generate. And once again, click Load to choose a preset. Just down here, you can see we have this cartoon grass. So click Apply, and you can see how the seed image is some grass. This is the original seed image. So I'm going to leave everything at its default and click Generate. And now we have some variations to choose from. Notice also that this result and the previous results were added into the history list. So what that means is I can select any history item, and it transfers all of its settings and the resulting images back up into the interface here, making it much easier to experiment without the risk of losing anything. I'm going to go back to the grass and choose one of these and click Import. For this, I'd like to have it full color and take the alpha from the luma and click Apply. All right, so there's my new grass. Click Apply. And now we've got a slightly different look. Very nice. In addition to the history, Particle Illusion saves out a PNG copy of every image generated to your hard drive. And this gives you the flexibility to open the files in Photoshop, for example, and make adjustments or create an alpha channel. And as I mentioned earlier, you can also use this tool to create high-res versions of existing sprites. Let's use this existing smoke preset as an example. See if we can make this look a little better with something high resolution. So I'm going to once again open up the Shape Editor and click on Generate, and click Load. And I'm going to choose this one here, Thin Smoke Wisps 1. Okay, so to generate a high-res version of this without really changing it, just to give some subtle variations, I'm going to increase the image strength right up to the max. And it's a very basic prompt there. And just click on Generate. And that gives us some 1024 size images, just with some subtle variations. And rather than clicking Import, this time I'm going to click Close, because I want to demonstrate that you can actually import these new generated images as a sequence. So if I navigate to my Generated Images folder, Here they are here. And these are numbered as an image sequence. So if I just click open, you can see that the dialog box shows 1 of 4. So this is really handy when you're making things like smoke and fire. I'm going to click apply and apply. And we need to make some adjustments. Bring the particle opacity right up to 100. There's a lot of particles there. I'll just make them a little bigger. And it's going to decrease the number. One thing I want to point out too, which is new in 2024, is being able to emphasize parameters. In a previous version, we added de-emphasis, but now you can emphasize as well, which makes it much easier to find things in these long lists. And you can right-click to emphasize or just double-click. So I'll bring the number right down. Let's go 20. Maybe a little bit more than that. Something like that. It's going to come back up to the top here. We've got use single frame and random start frame already selected. So that's going to choose a random frame from those 4 frames. So it just makes things like smoke and fire and that sort of thing much more realistic. A new inherited velocity option has been added to give your particles more natural movement. And this is done by inheriting the velocity from the parent emitter. And it can make a huge difference depending on the look you're creating. And here's an example where the particles have been rendered using regular velocity. And as you can see, it looks pretty unnatural. But if we add a little bit of inherited velocity, and with the particle selected, you'll find inherited velocity under the motion category, just down here. If I increase that to say 30, the whole look comes alive and feels like the particles are being affected by the movement of the talent. And this would have taken a lot more work in previous versions and still not look as good. So this is a great new addition to Particle Illusion 2024. And here's another example. This is without inherited velocity. And this is with inherited velocity. And you can see how inherited velocity really helps in these shots where the emitter is constantly changing direction. The next new feature is 3D lines. And I use lines all the time with my particle simulations, especially the trails feature added in Particle Illusion 2023.5. But up until 2024, these were simple 2D lines, and while they look good and they definitely enhance some simulations, they were limited when you added them in with Particle Illusion's 3D particles. In Particle Illusion 2024, we've included a new 3D lines parameter for emitters, and this converts all of the lines of that emitter into 3D objects. Here's one of the previous examples. But for this version, I've actually set up a camera to fly through the particle simulation. And while the particles themselves are responding to the camera and they're getting bigger as we get closer, the lines remain constant. They have a constant thickness. So with the emitter selected, if I come up and check 3D lines, check this out. Now the lines are 3D and they also respond to the position of the camera, which makes this much more effective. If you've got a camera nice and close to these lines, this can make a big difference. In the Continuum version of Particle Illusion, we've expanded the particle properties available inside the host. I'm working in After Effects. Notice down here in the Effect Control panel, we now have Inherited Velocity, Position and Size Turbulence, Affected by Fluids, Force Strength, also a brand new Master Size option. We'll look at that in a moment. Notice here I've set all of these to 0. If I just scrub through the timeline, you can see this looks like a pretty vanilla, boring simulation. But if I just turn these all back to 100, now they're displaying the full value of the settings that were set up in Particle Illusion, and you can see what a difference that makes. So obviously, having more parameters available inside the host makes things more flexible because you don't have to go back into Particle Illusion to make adjustments. And also, you can keyframe these parameters as well. For automatic animation, this gives you more options with the built-in Beat Reactor. But we've also added the master size parameter specifically with Beat Reactor in mind. Take a look at this side by side. Here I've linked master size to the Beat Reactor on the left and the original size parameter on the right. And because size is the size of the particle at birth, it's not obvious with Beat Reactor. But master size is the size of the particle at the current frame. And this makes the particles pulse to the beat, which is way more effective. Alright, so that's a quick look at what's new in Particle Illusion 2024. Look out for more in-depth tutorials coming soon. Be sure to visit borisfx.com to learn more. But for now, this is John. I'll see you in the next tutorial.